Kevin Mitnick, KnowBe4's chief hacking officer. And a lot of people ask me if they enable two-factor authentication on the websites that they use, does that stop phishing attacks? And let's take a look at that. So what exactly is two-factor authentication? That's when you log into a website, for example, and not only do you have to put in your username and password, but the website actually sends you a code via SMS, or you might have an application on your mobile device that displays a code that you have to enter into the website to log in. And that is proving that you actually have your mobile device. So it's a form of authentication that's based on something that you have, and your password is something that you know. So a good friend of mine developed this demo, Kuba Gretzky, that demonstrates how a bad guy could phish you even though you've enabled two-factor authentication. So let's take a look at how this works. So I'm logged into my Gmail account, and if you take a look in the second email here, I'll go ahead and open it. It appears to be an email from LinkedIn. And ordinarily, when somebody wants to join your network on LinkedIn, LinkedIn will actually send an email to your email address notifying you of that. And if you're interested, you can go ahead and click interested, log into your LinkedIn account, and authorize that person to actually become a connection. So if we take a look here, we have an email from LinkedIn that says, Kevin, I've read about your adventures and Ghosts in the Wires and so on, and this person wants to join my network. But this is actually a phishing attack. If we take a look here at where the email is originating from, it's not at linkedin.com, it's at this domain called llnked.com, which people might overlook. So let's go ahead and pretend that we're the victim here and go ahead and click on interested. And what that is going to do, it's going to redirect us to the LinkedIn website to go ahead and log in. But let's move this over to the right and let that load. And if you take a look over here, we have a blank white page, which is going to become very important in a moment. And this is the attacker terminal session. So let's go ahead and bring back the virtual machine that's now connected to LinkedIn to authenticate, because we, again, clicked on interested in the email. So we'll go ahead and put in a username, johnnyboy@mitnicksecurity.com. And now we're going to go ahead and put in our secret password. And now we're going to go ahead and click sign in. And when we click sign in, it's not going to allow us to log in. What LinkedIn is going to do is request our two-factor authentication code that LinkedIn is going to actually send to my mobile phone. And in a moment, you should hear a sound that the text message was received on my mobile phone. So let's go ahead and click sign in. And here we go. It's telling us that two-step authentication is enabled. We just heard a message come into my mobile device. We're going to uncheck this box that says recognize this device in the future. And I'm going to open my mobile device to take a look and see what the text message is, or what the code is rather. So the code here is 421-476. We're going to go ahead and click verify. And when we do so, it's going to log us into my LinkedIn account. So now we're logged into the LinkedIn account, but let's take a look at the attacker session over here on the left. So we're going to scoot this over to the right. And over here, what we have is what we're able to intercept. So we're able to intercept the email address, which is johnnyboy@mitnicksecurity.com. We're also able to intercept the password to the account, which is KnowBe4Rocks. And over here, this is not the actual six-digit code that was intercepted, because you can't really use the six-digit code again, the second factor. But what we're able to do is intercept the session cookie. And if you're able to steal the session cookie, or if rather the attacker is able to do so, they don't even need your username or password or second factor code. They could simply load the session key into a browser and they actually become you. So let me show you how this works. We're gonna highlight the cookie. We're gonna copy it to the clipboard. And then we're simply gonna open up Chrome in incognito mode. And incognito mode just means with privacy. So now we're going to go to the real LinkedIn website. And when we go here, obviously we're not authenticated. Now it's, you know, wants us to log in with our credentials, but we don't have to do so. We're going to go ahead and go into developer tools. We're going to go into the console. And what we're going to paste into the console is the session cookie that we stole from the victim, which was myself, by the way. I'm going to enter it. I'm going to head and close the session. Now, all I simply have to do to be logged into the victim's account with their session cookie is simply hit refresh now. So I hit refresh, and here we are. We've logged in, or rather hacked, my own account. So will two-factor authentication actually stop phishing attacks? Well, you can see that the answer is simply no. So what do you need to do to protect your organization? Well, of course, you need to have user education and training. That's a no-brainer. But you also have to conduct simulated phishing attacks so you can inoculate your users against this type of risk. And more importantly, you have to stop, you have to look and think before you click that link.